I walked into a honky-tonk one night down in New Orleans. Up above the bar hung a big guitar like none I'd ever seen. The neck was studded in diamonds, and although the strings were old, like kings of sound, they wound around six keys of solid gold. A man stepped up beside me. His breath was strong with wine. He said, "You know that guitar once belonged to a mighty close friend of mine. He used to play it right here. It was 45, I think. I could tell you quite a story, friend, if you could have buy me a drink." Well, possessed by every weakness that makes a man a fool, I bought a round, he drank it down, then he rocked back on his stool. He said, "Yes, I remember now. It was 45, all right. He just returned from the Great War. That's where he lost his sight. His buddies gave him that guitar. At the time, it was simple and plain. He added the gold and the diamonds as he played his way to fame. He was doing a show at Treforth the night he received a call to come appear at the Grand Ole Opry, the greatest show of them all. I was driving him to Nashville. It was wet, mist and rain. The signals flashed and the whistle screamed, but mister, I never even seen that train. I heard the doctor tell him just after he'd used his knife, "You're lucky, son, it was just your arm. It could have been your life." But he died late that night. Life demanded more than he could give. I thought he could have made it. He just lost the will to live. But the world's loss is heaven's gain. And tonight, he's still a star as he plays with a band of angels. That's my son's golden guitar.